Okay, good morning all of you all. I welcome you all for the online state level lectures of standard 9 geography, and I am Pratibha Dhende from SG Barvenagar school, and I am going to teach you all today. The lesson is 10th urbanization. Okay. Now you can see, you will notice that because of the factories near the village, the occupation of the people of the village has started changing. More and more people from outside come and start living in the village. Transport, hotels, restaurants, messes, retail shops, medical services, etc. start developing. As a result, the basic structure of the village start changing. So from geographical explanation, we come to know that when a village is there, and when for the first time the factory starts near the village, so what happens? Slowly the life of the people, the changes in the life of the people living in the village takes place. First is that the occupation of the people changes. As we all know that So we all know that the village people, what is the occupation of the village people? Basically agriculture. They do the farming. But as the factory is established near the village, so slowly the youth, the young generation, what they turn towards the working in the factory. So they change their occupation. What the forefathers, they're doing that farming, they don't go for that, but they go for the working in the factory. Then more and more people from outside come and start living in the village. So what does this mean? Now suppose a factory is started, and it is started where it will be starting in the village, in the little like taluka, means little bigger, okay, bigger city. So many villages are connected to that place. So what will happen? Many people from other villages also will start coming there, and they will also start living. Okay, they will also start living nearby that village. And as a result, what happens then? Transport system is very well developed then. Why? Because many people are traveling to that place. So this transport facilities are now more easier. Then frequently the transport system is done over there. Then hotels are also grown up. Okay, so people start living, wanted to live there, and they don't have place. So hotels also grow in that place. Then restaurants also. Why restaurants? Because the people, the workers come there in the factory. So they need the lunch and all, breakfast, lunch. So restaurants also are established over there. Then messes. Mess, you all know, the lunch and all is given in the tiffins. Okay. Then retail shops are also there. Established, then medical services, etc. start developing. So because of one factory, so many things are start developing in that particular region. As a result, basic structure of the village start changing. So what happened? Because of this established one factory established, all the basic structure, whatever the basic things are there needed for the people. Okay, so that are changing. The basic structure of village, how it was previously, there no transport system was there, no roads were there, no restaurant, nothing was there. But now the structure is totally changed of the village. Now people from the surrounding regions to work here, and thus the population of the village increases. Now you all know, in village the population is not more, because the particular people who are staying from the forefathers, only those generations are there, and most of the youth, what they do, they go to the cities. Okay, they go for higher studies, then they get the job over there, and they mostly settle over there only. But now as the factory established in the village, the people from the different regions surrounding the regions, okay, they come there and they settled over there. So what happened? The population of the village slowly start increasing. To fulfill their needs, other services also develop, like medical facilities, food, hospitals, recreations, etc. Now there are various different needs also. So to fulfill their needs, needs of the peoples are the services. Okay, the other services are also developed, which are those like medical facilities. Okay, good hospital should be there. Good welfare, health welfare system should be there. Then food, then recreation. Recreation means entertainment like theaters, okay, parks, museums, etc. Then consequently, the extent of the village grows and the form of earlier village changes. Now slowly, slowly what happens? The extent of the village grows, means the village grows in size, okay, and the form of the earlier village changes. As we have already seen that the village now slowly, slowly the village is progressing and the village is no more as it was previously. Now see, the Gram Panchayat providing public services to the village gives way to municipal council or municipal corporation. Now the Gram Panchayat, you must be knowing that this is a local body which provides public services, means all kinds of services to the village population. Okay, like how we have in the cities municipal councils or municipal corporation, big cities like Mumbai, Pune, they have the municipal corporation. So these are the bodies which look after the public services which has to be provided to the public. So these bodies provide the different basic services to the citizens. Okay, so these are providing different basic services. Okay, basic services to the citizens like drinking water. The drinking water should be safe there, that should be treated before supplying. Then roads, the condition of the road should be good. So they can maintain the condition of the road. This service also is provided by the body, these bodies. Then transportation, then sewage network, then street lighting, etc. Then street lighting is very important, because if the at night, if the street light is not there, so what is the use of the road there? Okay, so it is very important, and these are the basic services which are provided to the citizens of the of that particular region. Besides these, other facilities like town planning, then recreation facilities, tourist places, parks, etc. also need to be developed. So besides these other facilities, which are those are like town planning, means planning, proper planning should be there. So before a town has to be develop, okay, before developing the town, the proper planning is done by very expert people. Then recreation facilities, means already told that the theaters, then the parks, playgrounds for the children, all these things. Then tourist places, so you all must be knowing to what are, which are the tourist, many tourist places are there in Maharashtra and other states also. So people mostly go there to visit the places. Parks, etc. also need to be developed. So tourist places play very important role in those areas where factories and all other things are not established. So the people from that region, okay, so they can earn their living by the tourists are coming to their place, so they will be getting the income from there. Okay, so those people, the regions like the places like Mahabaleshwar, then Lonavala, then many places are there, Khandala, and many more. Okay, so those places, they get the income, most of the income is from the tourist coming to their place. Then now criteria for defining places as urban area. Now what are the criteria that we can say that this is a urban area? Now in the year 1961, the Census of India has decided to define urban on the basis of following criteria. Now census, you all are knowing, na, after 10 years the population is counted, so that is census. So in the year 1961 the Census of India was done, and on that basis only the criteria was decided for the urban. More than 75% of male working population should be engaged in non-agricultural occupation. This is very important to remember. More than 75%, okay, total population of the male, from that 75% of the male, they should be working. They should not be working in agriculture occupation. Okay, they should be engaged in non-agriculture. Non-agriculture means other than the agriculture. Then next criteria is the population of the settlement should be more than 5,000. Means now what? The population of the settlement, the population of that particular region should be more than 5,000. It should not be less than 5,000. Then the next one is the population density of the settlement should be more than 400 persons per square kilometer. Okay. The population density of that a region should be more than 400 persons per square meter. So these are the criteria. Then talking of the urbanization in India, the urban population has been increasing constantly from 1961 to 2011. Now, if we are talking about urbanization in India, we can say that the urban population has been increasing, okay, from the year 1961 to the year 2011. Okay, from 1961 to 1981, this growth was around 5.5 only, but from 1981 to 2011, this growth was around 13.73%. This means that the urban population is increasing rapidly in India. Now, what does this mean? In 1961 to 1981, the growth was around 5.5% only. But from 81 to 2011, this growth was around 13.73. So there was a much increase from 5.5 to 13.73. This means that the urban population is increasing rapidly in India. Means the population in the cities, okay, these are, the population is increasing very rapidly as compared to the village in India. Urbanization occurs because of many reasons. So there are many reasons why the urbanization takes place. We will study some of the main reasons. Now, first is the industrialization. The development and concentration of industries in our region is a factor contributing towards urbanization. Means what? The development and concentration of industries in a region, means in a particular region, how many factories, how many industries are developed. Okay, and the concentration means the amount, the quantity, how many are there and how much, to how much extent they are developed. So this is a very important factor which is contributing towards urbanization. Okay, because when industries are established, then only the urbanization of that particular region takes place. Then increase in industries leads to increase in the hopes of people who are attracted towards these industries from surrounding areas. This increases the speed of urbanization. Now, what does this mean? Increasing industries leads to increase in hope of people who are attracted towards these industries from surrounding areas. Means as the industries are increased, the people, what they do? They start attracting towards the industries. Means they want to go and work over there. This increases the speed of urbanization. Because of this, most of the people, means a large population, is engaged in industries, and thus the speed increases of urbanization. Now, in the 19th century, Mumbai grew rapidly because textile mills started on a large scale in Mumbai. So, in the 19th century, Mumbai grew rapidly. What is the reason? The reason is that the textile mills started over here in Mumbai on large scale. On large scale, the work textile mills were started. Then many villages which were originally fishing villages, that is Koliwadas, became part of Mumbai metropolitan area because of industrialization and urbanization. Now, what does mean many villages? Now, many village people which were only engaged in fishing. Okay. So, they are also known as Kolivadas. Okay. The people staying over there, they are only mainly doing the fishing and earning their living. That also become part of Mumbai metropolitan area because of industrialization. Okay. So, many industries were established in those areas also. And as a result, they also become a part of Mumbai metropolitan area. And thus, industrialization and urbanization also was established over there. Now, you can see in the picture, Mumbai in past, how it is. And now you can see Mumbai in present. So, you can see the changes. Very different it was previously. And now you can see so many buildings are there. And previously you can see the empty places there. So, you can see the changes in Mumbai also. Then now trade. A place in a region is sometimes favorable in terms of transport, loading, unloading, and storage of a good. Now, a place in a region is sometimes favorable means what? That place is good. Okay, good for what? For transport. Good, you can say easy. Okay, very easy for transportation, loading, unloading. Loading means you all know, na? That when we are exporting something, so we have to all the material which is packed, we have to load in the van, and unloading is we have to get it down from the van, and the storage of goods, and also storage of goods we have to do. So whatever the factory means the industry is there, then whatever the goods are produced, that has to be stored first. Then the transportation system is there, transportation takes place. So the place which is having all favorable things means very easy going, then that is there it is established first. This leads to development of trade and related services like business complexes, banks, credit societies, godowns, cold storage, houses, etc. start going. So now because of this, development of trade take place. Then the related to trade, which are the services like business complexes that develop, then banks are also needed, that also develop there. Then credit societies means the societies means that particular body that gives credit. Okay. So the people who need, then godowns you all know where it is stored. The goods, that cold storages, you must be knowing that the goods which need very cold climates, so that are stored over there. Their houses, etc. start growing. So many things are growing because of development of trade. Many other things are also developed. For example, Nagpur in India is centrally located in India. Okay. So, Nagpur is centrally located in India. Urbanization started increasing here because this location facilitates trade. Yes, this is a very important. You should know this. That as Nagpur is situated in the center of India, so this was very, means urbanization started increasing here because of that, because of the location. And because of that facility of trade also started over here. Now, mechanization and technology. So, you can see now in the left side pictures that they are doing the manually. Okay, farming is done manually. Here, and in the right side picture, you can see machinery is used. Tractor is used and the wheat cutting machine is used. Okay, so mechanization and technology, when it is used in any field, you can say farming also or any other field also, then the production is also fast, and whatever the we need means the work is speed up because of the use of machines and technology. Now mechanization and technology, we can see lot of advantages of mechanization and technology in various fields. So because of use of machines and technology, lot of advantages are there, we can see in different fields. Both are helpful to urbanization too, and both are very helpful for urbanization. In the recent decades, the use of technology has increased in agriculture. Now you can see the use of technology that is has been increased in agriculture. Previously the farmer was doing the farming and everything, whatever the sowing of seeds, the harvesting, everything he was doing manually. Means the use of the, he was making the use of the bullocks and only the labors. But because of the use of technology, the agriculture work is now speed up. Mechanization has also increased. In rural areas, agriculture is done with the help of machines on a large scale these days. Okay, mechanization also increased, means machines are used. In rural areas, now agriculture is done with the help of many machines. Okay, on a large scale, machines are used. The manpower employment in agriculture became devoid of agricultural work. So now the hard work whichever has to be done by the manpower, okay, the laborers has to do all the hard work, that now has been reduced because of the use of the machines. This working class came to cities to look for work, and because of that now this is very important, that those were totally depending upon the agricultural work, okay, the laborers and all. Now because of the machines, what happened? The farmer is using the machine. Because why? Because he will get the work done very faster, and the whatever the wages he has to pay the this one laborers, that are also less now, because he has to just pay to the machine, whatever the machine operator. So now those people, that class which was working as a laborers in the agriculture, what they did now, they start coming to the cities for work. As a result, urban population also increasing. So because of this is also reason, so they are not having the work in the rural areas of agriculture. So now they are coming to the cities, and thus the population of the city increases. Now transport and communication. Now you can see transport means what? Whatever the means of transport are there, that is the railway, airways, waterways, okay. Then in that, the important one is migration. Now migration is important factor affecting urbanization. This migration can be short term, long term, or permanent. Migration occurs from rural to rural area, rural to urban area, or urban to urban area. The attraction of higher standard of life has also resulted in an increase in migratory population in the cities. For example, migration occurs to Mumbai, Pune from other parts. Now, what does migration means? Migration means the particular people, means a group of people, okay, they go and settle in some other area. Okay, that may be for a short time, long time, or permanent also. Or that can be now suppose the example is there. Now we have seen that the village, the people who are working in the farms. So because of the machines, they are not getting jobs over there. They don't get the work. So what they do? They move towards the cities. Now that group of people that is migrated from the rural areas to the cities. Now if they get the job, good job, so they will be long term. And if they are getting the job just for a few days, then that will be short term. They will be working for a few days, few months, then moving back to the village. But if they get a very good job, then they try to settle permanently in that region. Okay. So migration occurs from ruler to ruler area. Yes, migration can be from ruler to ruler area. Now the example is, now suppose one village is having a small scale factory. Okay. So those people who don't get the work in their village, they will go over there. So ruler to ruler area. Then ruler to urban means now village to cities. Okay. Then urban to urban areas means cities to cities. Okay, that can be from Mumbai to Pune or Pune to Mumbai, urban to urban. Okay. Then ruler to urban, you can say that a particular village from that village to Mumbai or from that village to Pune. The attraction of higher standard of life has also resulted in an increase in migratory population in the cities. Now, what does this mean? The attraction of higher standard of life means what? They are attracted towards the life of the standard of living of the people in the cities. Okay. So, those example is the youth. Okay. The youth in the village, they are mostly attracted towards the cities because of the, or they think that here is very glamour in the city. They can enjoy themselves. Okay. And they can live the good standard of living over here, higher standard of living. So that particular group is, means every year that group is migrated. For example, migration occurs to Mumbai or from Pune to other parts. Okay, this is also an example you can see. Now, what are the reasons for migration? We have seen industrialization, because of establishment of industries, then trade. We have seen how the trade takes place, where that particular region which is very having all favorable conditions for trade. Then because of trade, many other services are also developed in that region, particular region. Then mechanization and technology, use of the machines and technology in different fields. Okay, because of that also urbanization increases. Then transport and communication. Then transport and communication system has developed, because of that also, these are the reasons for urbanization. Then migration, we have seen now only that people, a particular group of people migrate from one place to another. That can be from ruler to ruler or from ruler to urban or from urban to urban. And that can all be, migration can be for a short time, long term, or can be a permanent also. Now, transport and communication. In regions where transport facilities like roads and railways develop, urbanization of small rural settlements occurs rapidly over there. Means what now? The regions where transport facilities, okay, transport facilities like roads, railways are developed, means they are very well developed. Urbanization of small rural settlements occurs rapidly over there. Means now urbanization takes place over there where transport facilities are good, developed, and small rural settlement also occurs over there. For example, after the development of Konkan Railway, many villages like Savare district, Ratnagiri, lying close to its proximity, has started urbanizing. Now the example they have given, that after the development of Konkan Railway, okay, you must be knowing that Konkan Railway has been developed. So many villages, they have given the example of Savare, that is located in the district Ratnagiri, that is lying close to its proximity, has started urbanizing. Because of the development of Konkan Railway, this particular Savare has now started developing more and urbanizing. Convergence of important rail routes through Bhusawal, that is district Jalgaon, lead to its rapid development, rapid growth. Now, because of the rail routes which are developed through Bhusawal, that also leads to rapid growth. Okay. So till migration, we have completed. We have completed half of the lesson. So we'll just revise it, what we have seen today. Okay. So first thing we have seen that urbanization. Then we have seen main reasons of urbanization. What are the main reasons? Then we have seen industrialization. Then we have seen trade, mechanization and technology, transport and communication, and migration. Okay, so we will revise it. Okay, so what is urbanization? We have seen a village turns into a town or a city. Okay, so you can basically remember this in short, that a village turns into a town or a city is urbanization. The basic structure of village starts changing because the factory near the village attracting people from outside, transport, hotels, restaurant, messes, retail shops, medical services, etc. start developing in the village. Okay, so we have already seen how the urbanization takes place because of the basic structure of the village then slowly changes. Okay, first the factories developed, because of that population from the other village also people come and start over there, settling there. Then many different facilities like transport, hotels, that different things are started in the village. And because of that, the basic structure of the village totally changes. Then we have seen how to define the basic criteria to define an area as urban. So the first is, we have seen that out of the total population, 75% of the male population should be engaged in non-agriculture occupation. Non-agriculture means other than agriculture. They should not be engaged in agriculture. The population of settlement should be more than 5,000. So remember this, the population should be more than 5,000. The population density of the settlement should be more than 400 per square kilometer. So remember this, the population density should be more than 400 persons per square meter. Then, what are the reasons we have seen for urbanization? Industrialization, trade, mechanization, and technology, transport and communication, and the last one is migration. Okay, so these are the basic points you have to remember. These are the keywords, remember, then you can elaborate these in details. Now, industrialization is what? The development and concentration of industries in a region. Okay, in a particular region, the development and concentration of industries contributing towards urbanization. Increase in industries leads to increase in the hope of people who are attracting towards these industries from surrounding areas. This increases the speed of urbanization. Okay, because of industries, the people start attracting towards that. For and as a result, many people means a population is attracted towards that particular region, and thus the speed of increases the speed of urbanization. Then trade. A place in a region is sometimes favorable in terms of transport, loading, unloading, storage of goods. This leads to development of trade and related services. Okay, like the business complexes, banks, credit societies, godowns, cold storage, houses, etc. start growing there. Okay, then the next one is mechanization and technology. Mechanization and technology are helpfully to urbanization. In the recent decades, the use of technology and mechanization has increased in India. Okay, so because of the use of technology and mechanization, the use of it has increased in agriculture. In rural areas, agriculture is done with the help of machines on a large scale these days. So rural areas, they have started using the machines for the work which has to be done in the farm. The manpower employed in agriculture became devoid of agriculture work. Because of the use of the machines for the farm work, now the group of people which were doing the work in the farm, okay, that group of people, now they are not getting the work. They are devoted from the work. So this class, working class, now what they do? They start going to the cities and in search of work. So what happens because of this? As a result, urban population start increasing. So because of this also, the population of the urban start increasing. So mechanization and technology also plays very important role. Now the next one is transport and communication. Now in regions where transport facilities like roads, railways, okay, the region where transport facilities like roads and railways are developed, urbanization of small rural settlements occurs rapidly over there. So where the roads and railways are developed, their urbanization takes place, okay, of small rural settlements occurs. Small settlements of rulers come and settle over there, and thus slowly that grows rapidly there. Now the example is, after the development of Konkan Railway, many villages like Savardi district, Ratnagiri, lying close to its proximity, has started urbanizing. So we have seen this example that because of the development of Konkan Railway, many regions over there, many areas close to that example, they have given the village Savardi. Savardi is the village where in Ratnagiri district that has now started urbanizing. Because of what? Because of the development of Konkan Railway. So that has become, because of the development of Konkan Railway, many people can travel to that place. Okay. Then convergence of important railway routes through Bhusawal, that is Jalgaon, lead to its rapid growth. So because of the important railway routes are there, convergence of important railway routes through Bhusawal. Okay. So many railway routes are going through Bhusawal, that is district Jalgaon. That also has lead to rapid growth. Okay. So transport and communication also plays very important role for urbanization. Okay. Now, reasons for migration. Now, migration is an important, very major factor affecting urbanization. So, we have seen migration. So, it plays a very important role affecting urbanization. This migration can be short term, long term, or permanent. So, as we have already seen, that migration can be for a short time, long time, or permanent also. Then migration occurs from rural to rural areas. Okay, this is one example, that rural to rural area. That suppose one village is having the industry established. Okay, so that particular village will that place will be attracted by the other rural people. Okay, they will come and work there. So migration of many people will be taking place. Then rural to urban or urban to urban areas. So these rural to urban, we can see many times that from particular village, they are going to the cities, okay, for working, in search of work only. Then they settle over there. Then urban to urban also, from one city to other city, okay, the group of people migrate. Then the attraction of higher standard of living has also resulted in an increase in migratory population in the cities. Now, what does this mean? Now, attraction of higher standard of life has also resulted in an increase in migratory population in the cities. Means what? The standard of living, how the people live in the cities. Okay, that is mostly liked by the people living in the villages. Mostly the youth. Okay, young people. So they are always attracted. Okay, they are always thinking that when they will be grow older and then they will be going to the cities so that they can enjoy the standard, higher standard of life over there. So many people means the youth, when they complete their studies, they come to the cities or the urban places in the search of work, and slowly what they do, they settle over there. And as a result, why they settle over there? Because they are they are attracted towards the standard of living of the people in the cities. Okay. The example they have given, that for example, migration occurring in cities like Mumbai, Pune from other part of India. So these are the cities where the maximum people are migrated from all over the India. Not only from Maharashtra, but from all over the India. Okay. So here we have finished our half of the lesson, and the next part we will be studying tomorrow. So whatever we have finished, read that. Till migration, you read. Okay, and the next part will be continued tomorrow. Okay, I hope students, you all have understood the lesson. Okay, thank you, students.
Thank you so much, Pratibha ma'am.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.